November 2021 has been an epic month for Tesla. Elon Musk sold approximately $10 billion worth of Tesla stock. And because of that, the stock reacted by doing nothing. It's pretty much flat, a bit up, and within range of its all-time highs, at a valuation of over $1 trillion. We've seen in the previous video that to understand the price action on Tesla, you need to follow what's happening in its options market. Tesla is unlike any other stock. In this one, we're going into the heart of the battle and we'll see how Musk executed his trades and how he controls the narrative. You and I don't need to guess about what's going on the other side of the trade. There's a bid offer spread that provides you with a clear indication. It's valid for retail traders, but for large volumes, it's different. You can move the market. And if the market knows you have to offload a massive amount, it can move even before you start selling. As a benchmark, any trade of over 10,000 stocks is considered a block trade and usually executed through a dark pool where trades are anonymous. This is also a battlefield tactic, but when you're a CEO, every trade is public. They are disclosed to the SEC in the US and they will be published. We know how many stocks Elon sold and at what price. And you can see that for $10 billion, there's a lot of reports. And each report included a lot of lines of trades, but that's not the whole picture. In fact, these lines are averages. They represent many trades, possibly hundreds. So how could that happen in practice? He was not calling his brokers every minute and executing manually. We've explored it with an expert, BMO's Joe Wald.
And algorithmic trading is really the methodology in which institutional clients leverage their access to executing a trade. When you've got a fragmented market where you've got multiple places where you can execute, and you also have high frequency trading trying to get an edge based on what they're seeing in the marketplace, it becomes an incredible challenge for an institutional client to be able to execute their orders without signaling or creating a lot of market impact. An institutional client that's looking to trade electronically to execute a large block is leveraging a liquidity sourcing strategy that's going to work the order based on a quantitative kind of arrival price kind of strategy. It's also going to look to see if there's any large blocks of liquidity that take place in some of the dark pools or some of the venues that are at midpoint.
The tactic used to manage Musk's order was in fact invented by high frequency traders, the same type of hedge funds that like to short Tesla. So this is like modern warfare in the markets, using sophisticated techniques to gain an edge. That and the huge volume on the Tesla stocks and options explain why the stock price barely moved. But even that brilliant execution needs some reinforcement. Musk has a powerful weapon to control the narrative. You can't underestimate the importance of the tweets. First, it's how he rallies his troops. But there's a secondary effect. All media outlets pick up the tweets and transform it into front page news. So let's analyze the infamous tweet. There is a tax reference, but the legislation he's referring to was pretty much dead already at the time of the tweet. So that's irrelevant. The poll implies causality. But what we've learned since is that the first part of the sale had actually been prearranged in September. Then he added that he doesn't get a salary, so the only way to pay taxes is to sell stock. Indeed, Elon doesn't draw any salary. Instead, he owns shares and gets stock options, which is what triggered the whole thing. But the part about selling stocks is not that clear. He only sold twice before because he doesn't need it. When you're the wealthiest person in the world, you use the stock as collateral, and that's how you pay the bills. So the second part of the sentence isn't exactly true. He doesn't really absolutely have to sell any stock. He could just use more collateral. In the footnote of the form for disclosure to the SEC, we can see that some stocks were indeed for tax reasons, but others were for no reason at all. This tweet is vintage Musk, a mix of entertainment, factual statement that has become its signature move. Even short sellers like Carson Bock acknowledge his mastery. Tweets are not editable, but what if we would rewrite it based on what we learned? Could that have a different impact on the market? What's important is the narrative. The market wants to know, why is the CEO selling? Could he be losing faith or losing interest in the company? Or is the stock too high? Other CEOs, such as Bezos and Zuckerberg, sell stock and regularly. But Musk's execution is different and a lot riskier potentially. It's very concentrated in time, near the top, and for more significant amounts than any other CEO. I've got to admit that I'm with Carson Buck on that one.
I used to be very negative on him. As a person, you know, I am, in the sense that he lies a lot.
I don't particularly like Elon, but I admire what he's building. And after this investigation, I also admire his trading. The tactics are not pretty, but they work. And if this battle is a game,
we play the man, not the ball. Playing the ball would be getting into the technology.
Then he's not a player that you want to play against. Please tell me what you think or ask any questions. I reply to all the comments. And stay tuned for more investigations into financial markets and the future of investing.